First, we want to get to your top stories. First, here at 8, a 15-year-old accused of sexual assault earlier this year is now suspected in another sex assault incident.
The incidents happened at two different high schools. Fox 5's Melanie Alnwick live at Loudoun County Public School headquarters with this story. Disturbing details, Mel.
That's right, and many have questions, including why was this suspect allowed to go back into another school, and why didn't the school system or the sheriff's office notify the community about the first arrest, the first assault back in May? And that was when a student at Stonebridge High School in Ashburn reported to a school resource officer that she'd been sexually assaulted in a bathroom. After a two-month investigation, a 14-year-old fellow student, who is now 15, was arrested and charged in July. The boy's court appearance was pushed back because DNA evidence wasn't ready, so he was released from custody but required to wear an ankle monitor and have no contact with the victim. The girl's father was arrested for disorderly conduct during a school board meeting in June. Scott Smith has gone public with his story on Fox News. He said he was trying to speak about his daughter's assault.
Under the impression from the prosecutor that this sexual predator was being held on in-house arrest with an ankle monitor and would not return to school until these court sessions were done. You know, you're innocent until you're proven guilty, I understand that, but we do have to protect everyone at the same time.
Now, because the teenage suspect's case was still pending at the start of this school year, he was enrolled at nearby Broad Run High School. On October 6, he was arrested again and charged with sexually assaulting another girl. He is now back in juvenile detention. Now, Loudoun County Public School says it worked with police, and as a rule, they do not conduct their own investigations when it comes to criminal matters until that criminal matter is resolved in the courts or in the juvenile system. The sheriff's office says they didn't send out a community notification because the victim and the suspect in the May incident were known to each other, and they did not want to inadvertently identify the victim of a sexual assault.
A lot to unpack there, Mel. Can you explain in a little bit more detail why the teen was released after that first arrest?
Right. So we talked with the Commonwealth's attorney, and she says that there were no indications that this teen would reoffend. They had conversations with the parole office. They had conversations with the victim's family. And it was determined that based on history, that it would be okay to release him back to the community.
Thank you for that update, Mel. We'll continue to follow this story here on Fox 5.